Let's go to Anonymous, listening in Brentwood, California, listening online. How are you, Anonymous?
Hi, Father. I'm good. I have an in-law, family member in-law, that I'm not terribly close to, but is pregnant. She's pregnant by in vitro fertilization.
Right.
And I'm having trouble kind of dealing with the situation.
Sure.
I'm having trouble being congratulatory to her and just even touching the topic about it.
Yeah.
Sometimes I even question whether or not this child should exist, and I was wondering if that's right or not.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just wondering how to go about, if I should ever even bring it up with her, or I'm not terribly close to her. I never had the chance to know, to take the time to let her know that this wasn't a moral choice.
Sure.
She is Christian. She's not Catholic, but she is Christian.
Well, there may be an ill-formed conscience here, right? Because many people think that the church says children are good and we should have as many of them as we can and by whatever means. And that needs some distinctions, as you obviously know, because children are to come about in a human way. And the human way is the one flesh within the covenant of marriage. So I think what we could say here is that the means by which the child has come into being are contrary to God's will, in the same way that if a child is born out of wedlock, God does not want that to be the case. But once the child has come to be, the child is a child of God. And the child, of course, is innocent of its own origins. So it's a fine line to walk there. But once the child has come into existence now, the child is a child of God. I think it would be good at some point if you try to explain this to your family member. I think you're going to have to lay a little bit of groundwork first, but I would encourage it to clarify, because there might be a conversion of heart that can happen down the road.